Joining us right now to weigh in on all this news today, we have Bullseye Brief author and publisher Adam Johnson, also someone I used to host a show with, and Fox News contributor Gary Kaltbaum. Let me go to you first. I mean, and I would just preface this by saying I know Larry well.
Yes.
He is a wonderful person.
Yep.
And a brilliant economist.
Agreed.
Former member of the Reagan administration, obviously has worked very closely with Art Laffer.
Yes.
Art, whom we just spoke to, is on a plane. Otherwise, he'd be on this show right now talking about Gary and what he... Larry, and what he could do for our economy and for policy. But the one thing that I find somewhat interesting about this is, you know, he is not a guy, Larry, that is, that likes tariffs. And in
fact, he
recently penned an op-ed with Art and with Steve saying, you know, tariffs are not the way to go. So how's that going to reconcile itself within the White House, shall we
say? I actually worked with Larry at one point. When I was a young options trader at ING Furman Sells, Larry was our economist, and he would come out to the trading floor of 600 people, and I would always say, here comes Captain America. You know, Larry's just so gung-ho and believes so much in the capitalist system. I think his tagline is, capitalism is the best path forward for prosperity in America, period. Larry Kudlow.
Yeah.
And he's just so gung-ho, so enthused. He's also highly educated. He's a very smart guy. I think he's going to be an outstanding advisor to the president. And you know what? As the president himself said, Trish, they don't entirely agree on everything, but that's okay. No one always agrees on everything, right?
Right.
Husbands and wives who've been married for 30 years don't agree on everything. That's okay.
Yeah.
I think the point here is Larry is Captain America. He believes strongly in the capitalist system. Honestly, Trish, I always kind of thought Fox was going to make him an anchor here.
Oh.
He's kind of one of us, Trish.
Wow.
I mean, you know, he believes and he's a supporter.
Yes.
And it just, you know.
Larry used to tell me he never met a tax cut that he didn't like. And you know, there's a real truth to what's happening in this economy right now. Mr. Kaltbaum, we've got tax reform, lower taxes, helping to unleash some of that, what they call animal spirits in the economy. And they're talking about round two coming on tax reform. In fact, Kevin Brady telling our own Stuart Varney this morning that he's gearing up for round two. I would imagine that Larry Kudlow would be very significant and helpful as we look forward to phase two of tax cuts.
Give me round two, give me round three, give me round four. Look, the taxpayer has been screwed for many years, paying too much money into the system. And the other part of Kudlow, he loves smaller government. If he can get into the Republicans' ears on the size of government spending every year, then you get the big trifecta with the free trade also. Now, something that was said today that I'm hopeful on with the tariffs is using tariffs as a negotiating point instead of as a hammer. If you want to use it that way and you negotiate well, then we can get something done. The fact is, there are bad players around the globe. There is something that does need to be done. We can do better on trade, and hopefully that's the route they're going.
You got to be careful, though, right? You got to be, if you're going to use it as a negotiating tool, you can't tell everyone you're going to use it as a negotiating tool.
Or get too easy.
You've already seen Boeing, billions of dollars of market cap, come off just because of this reason right now. So there is a fine line. That's something that we have to watch very closely as we move forward.
Indeed. Talking about tariffs here, I mean, I'm repeating myself, but I just love this example that Congressman Sean Duffy gave me the other night when I was in for my friend Lou Dobbs.
Let's hear it.
And he said that, look, he's got Harley Davidson out there in Wisconsin. And he said, yes, they're going to have to pay more for their raw materials. And that means maybe slightly higher motorcycle prices. But he said, think about what could happen for that company if they're able to sell more of those motorcycles in places like India if we get rid of some of the tariffs. He said they have a 100% tariff right now on Harley-Davidson motorcycles in India. If you get rid of those tariffs, gosh, you have an opportunity to sell much more, and maybe that starts to offset some of these higher prices for steel and aluminum. What are your thoughts on that, Adam?
I hope it does. And when Tim Cook, the CEO of Apple, went over to India, the reason he did that was because there was a rule on the books in India that said you can't open retail stores in India unless 80% of the components of the stuff you're selling is made in India. You can understand why a new economy would want to do that. They're trying to build their own economy.
And by the way, China does the same kind of stuff.
Of course. But guess what? India, China, they are building their economies, and they're now no longer, I mean, they're still emerging, but They're a force to be reckoned with. They're some of the largest economies in the world. So it does make sense for them to open it up and to get rid of those tariffs. And what the president's doing is creating leverage. This whole thing has been about leverage in NAFTA. It was never about Chinese steel. As we said the other day, Trish, only 1.5% of Chinese steel ever finds its way to U.S. shores. Mm-hmm. This was about creating leverage, and I fully support what he's doing. Yeah. I'm enthused. I love it.
Is the market overreacting yet again? I mean, look, industrials are recovering a little bit here, but they are still down.
We're adjusting.
Today, and we've got a market that's, you know, off 150. Take a look, some of the industrials down. You know, they have to come to terms with what these tariffs will mean. Go ahead, Gary.
On the market, just don't blink right now. Just remember the other part of the equation. We had a monstrous run for 15 months that ended at the end of January. I think it was about 6 or 7 years of gains in 15 months. It is normal to consolidate those gains from month in, month out, and I think we have a few more months to go where we're just going to back and fill, and then if things are good going forward and interest rates stay low and earnings remain strong, we're going to bust out of here again.
Yes.
But it's going to be a little bit down the road. You just can't go straight up forever. And you don't have to worry about the markets going back and forth a few percent. It's a normal course of business right now.